What's up, you guys? Welcome to Enter the Dungeon. And in today's video, we're talking about five crypto gaming tokens to watch out for in December. And these games, they got it all. I mean, they hit all the narrative sweet spots for crypto this year. NFT, Metaverse, gaming, DeFi, and a little bit of spicy DAO. You know, some decentralized autonomous organization narrative thrown in there. Okay, but before we jump in, you know, I got to give you that dreaded disclaimer just to make the lawyers and everybody happy. Always do your own research. Nothing on this channel is financial advice. Everything on here is educational and informational purposes. This is just stuff I'm interested in and I'm sharing in. Always, always, always do your own research. Ape responsibly, be a big boy and a big girl and do your own research. Okay, gotta say it. So let's dive in. What gaming plays are we talking about today? All right. Number one, DefiKingdoms. Ticker is Jewel. Number two, Magic. Ticker is also Magic. Number three, Star Atlas on the Solana ecosystem. Ticker is Atlas. Number four, Illuvium. Ticker ILV. And number five, Alien Worlds. Ticker TLM. All right, now do me a real quick favor. If you're new here, click subscribe, hit the like button, hit the bell notification, and I'll drop these gems and these alpha drops on your phone once, twice a day sometimes. And also do me a big favor, go over to my website, dungeon.fyi, drop in your email address. I'll send you an email once or twice a week with news and updates on DeFi and different gems I'm looking at. And you'll get first access to my Discord and lifetime free access to any paid channel that I introduce in there. Okay, let's dive in. All right, you guys all know that the market just like took a massive you-know-what over the last week or so with Big Daddy Bitcoin dragging everybody down, but there are certain narratives that have been holding up much better. One of those is gaming, Web3, Metaverse, and the whole Luna Terra ecosystem. Maybe we'll do a video on that. But in this video, we're just going to focus on a few of these, you know, Metaverse and NFT play-to-earn gaming tokens that are being built. I have strong belief that the gaming narrative is honestly just getting started, with a lot of these coins like just barely having, you know, videos out, some of them having working alpha and beta products and stuff like that. But the space is still so young. And this is, in my opinion, along with a lot of other people's, the gaming space is definitely going to be the space that like drags in the masses. NFTs are cool. You know, L1s are cool for the tech heads and all that stuff. But really, most people, like the mass majority of people out there sitting in their mama's basement or doing their thing, they just want to play the video games, right? So that's what we're talking about today. And at number one is DefiKingdoms with the ticker Jewel. A lot of people on my Twitter feed going nuts over this one. They have a working product that you can play right now on the Harmony ecosystem. You can connect your Harmony enabled MetaMask wallet and pretty much start playing it now, buying and selling and trading Jewel live in the app and using it to do stuff like farm. And you know, I have not, just an FYI, I've not personally played any of these games, so everything here is really just kind of surface. I'm just taking a look at it and throwing a shout out to these projects so you guys can do a little bit deeper research, okay? But looking at the chart over the last 3 months, definitely like it's just been ranging in here. So in my opinion, there's definitely like some good time to grab Jewel like at any time over the last few weeks, 3 months. You know, it's just kind of going up and down. Let's dive into a little bit more about what DefiKingdoms is. DefiKingdoms blends the appeal of decentralized finance and the current rise of play-to-earn economics. It is live on the Harmony One network right now. So you use the Jewel token, right? It's used to purchase useful items, unique NFTs such as heroes and kingdoms in the game, as well as various in-game items. Not only is the token used in-game, it is also used for liquidity mining to earn more through staking. Jewel is a governance token, so holders will have a say in the growth and evolution of the project. So if you're a holder, you can actually use that to make votes, I assume. And you can use it to add liquidity and probably to stake and earn in different ways like that. So we got DeFi, we got gaming, we got NFT, all this stuff. And it's on the Harmony ecosystem, which has been getting a lot of traction this year. Really, to play, you just need the Harmony One wallet enabled on your MetaMask, and you can start interacting with the dApp and playing with it right away. Let's take a look at the website real quick. So now on the website, DefiKingdoms.com, you can see that it's a DeFi game built on the blockchain designed with usable NFTs. So you can actually buy and earn NFTs and use them in different utility use cases in the game itself. You can start playing it right now. You can watch a little trailer down here if you want. You can buy and trade Jewel right in their swap functionality, right in their app. You can see that there's all different kinds of DeFi ways to earn. You can swap, you can add liquidity to the pool. You can farm in their gardens, and I believe you can earn staking bonuses in the bank. Correct. I don't know. It looks like there's a lot of stuff coming soon, like Metaverse land, for example, and looks like more NFT stuff. They've got a solid roadmap down here, but I don't want to go too deep. Let's just click on the start playing button and see what happens. So, enable to jump in and start using this app, you will need to be connected in your MetaMask wallet. So, I'm connected in MetaMask, and it looks like since I don't actually have any one, which is the native protocol or the native token, excuse me, for Harmony, I would need to get a little bit of one to start playing. I assume there's like gas fees and things like that just to buy and trade Jewel. So, without one, there's not much you can do. So, let's see what happens if I say click here to get started. All right, this just takes you to a tutorial, which I think is pretty cool. And you can walk through it and get to know the product a little bit. So if you want to play this game, you need to get Harmony on the MetaMask. So find a tutorial for that. You can see I'm connected to the Harmony mainnet right here. You'll need to get a little bit of one, the native token for Harmony. And then you need to probably buy some Jewel and start playing. Okay, let's move on to number two. All right. Magic number two on the Arbitrum network. You can see this one's had a massive run up, and if this gaming, you know, if this dip is going to continue to rise from here, right? We had a big dip and now it's corrected and stuff is starting to move up again. If that's the case and it continues to go up a little bit for December, I'm not going to make that call. This could be a pretty solid entry point, and we might see this token Magic move up easily another 30-40%. I'm not saying it's going to break these all-time highs, but it could be a decent entry point right here. It was initially a loot derivative, an NFT collection. Treasure has transformed into a sprawling ecosystem that sits at the intersection of DeFi, NFTs, and gaming. Our dual resource economy composed of Magic and treasures are meant as a bridge between wider crypto metaverses. So they're essentially bridging assets and moving NFTs between metaverses and adding liquidity and enabling some of this stuff to move cross-chain and to be utilized cross-chain. So I think that's pretty cool. That's definitely a big narrative right now is cross-chain stuff happening. Again, Magic is the ticker. I'm not totally sure where to buy it. Let's take a look. So right now it looks like currently the only exchange available is SushiSwap on Arbitrum with the Magic WETH pair. Okay, so the price is right around $1 right now, topped out right around $1.60. So there's definitely some upside here if you believe the narrative that these are going to continue to explode. And you can see that the chart looks pretty strong too. We had a little spike, a little dip, and then it's crawled its way back up. Let's take a look at the website real quick. Treasure.lol, Treasure LOL. The Metaverse Bridge World governed by Treasure DAO. So I think that's cool, right? They're using actually a DAO. Like we've seen a lot of this stuff with a lot of other tokens, like rebase tokens, to actually create governance and to get the community involved in deciding on how the project is going to move forward. Let's read what they have to say. Treasure bridges the growing network of metaverses through an open and composable approach to the convergence of NFTs, DeFi, and gaming. A lot of buzzwords in there. We see a lot of this stuff on a lot of projects right now, so it doesn't mean a ton to me just by reading their copy. You know, it's definitely hitting some of those narrative sweet spots that are growing right now. How treasure works. All right, so magic is the natural resource of the treasure metaverse, which powers on NFTs and turns them from fantasy into productive yield-bearing assets. So you can use magic to take an NFT and turn it into a yield-bearing asset and earn from it. Magic is designed to be increasingly scarce, so it's deflationary, emissions declining as complexity of the economy increases as it weaves an ever-growing web of narrative bridges within the metaverse. A lot of big ideas. Will it actually come to fruition? I don't know. It's hard to say. Let's see if we can watch some of this trailer. Okay, the trailer looks cool. Does it give me a really good sense of what the game is going to be? No, not exactly. But this, again, there's a lot of FOMO around this project. There's a lot of hype. And let me know in the comments what you think about Magic, all right? Let's move on to the next one. All right, Star Atlas, ticker Atlas on the Solana ecosystem. You guys may already know that I'm pretty bullish on this project. I do have a small position, and I have already done a video on Star Atlas. So you can go back through my collection and check out my video on Star Atlas. Looks like a pretty solid entry point here too, just getting wrecked over the last couple weeks and trying to claw its way back up into the 12 cent range, topped out around 18 cents. Again, if you believe the narrative that we're gonna just keep the music going forever in the crypto gaming world, there could be some upside here. So this coin like has definitely moved. It's gone its distance already. Will it keep going forever? I don't know. They still have not even come out, as far as I know, with a working beta product. They have an awesome trailer. They have an awesome website. They have all the narratives woven in. It's a very grandiose idea, but will it make it? I don't really know. Let's just check out the website really quick. It's pretty cool. They definitely have a great creative team. You can click here to enter. Click play now. So here you'll have to connect your wallet and get started. So I may be wrong. In the last video I did for this, I believe there wasn't a working product. It could be that I'm wrong here and that you can actually get in and start playing a beta or something like that, but I haven't done it. So go to their website, staratlas.com, play.staratlas.com for the dApp and check it out for yourself and let me know what you think. And let's move on to Illuvium. Illuvium, another massive gaming project that just looks insane. That's getting a ton of hype on crypto Twitter and YouTube and everywhere. And this coin already has run up to like $1,600 and is now kind of ranging in that $1,200 to $1,300 range. So it could be that there's a little bit of upside if your goal is to trade this. But if it's for a long-term hold, I think that this is potentially a pretty solid one with a project that's already gotten a lot of hype and already has like working betas that you can get involved in with some. I don't think it's publicly available right now, but it all looks pretty cool. So Illuvium is, let's read a little bit more about it right here. So Illuvium is an open world fantasy battle game built on the Ethereum blockchain. Often touted as the first AAA game on Ethereum, Illuvium looks to provide a source of entertainment to both casual gamers and hardcore DeFi fans through a range of collecting and trading features. So this is something that I think is really cool. This is like a nice unique little perk. Although Illuvium is secured by Ethereum, it is built on Immutable X. It's a layer two solution that's designed to help scale applications with NFT functionality. That's Immutable X. So essentially, I don't know if all the functionality in the dApp will be essentially free to transact on, but Immutable X, the NFT functionalities that they've built, you can essentially buy and trade NFTs and transact on Immutable X with basically zero gas fees. So that's pretty cool. If they can integrate that into their entire gaming system and you don't have to deal with Ethereum gas fees, that's a big deal right now. Let's take a look at their website. So I like their website. It's really well done. You can go down here and register. So you can just go down here and drop in a little email address and says, thank you for joining. Wait till you see the next update. So I think essentially by joining, you're just getting on their email list right now and they'll update you when stuff is ready. But you can go onto YouTube and you can see different people are already playing and playing the beta, I think, and playing this game. Let's take a look at some of this stuff going on their trailer. Very sappy music. I'm sorry, but that's a red flag. It looks cool though, gotta say. But that music, what? Does look dope, gotta say. All right, so a bunch of cute creatures battling it out, and you can like buy and trade NFTs and do all this kind of stuff. But I gotta say, like, of all these projects, this one, it does have a pretty unique feel. It does have a lot of stuff going for it. I'm bullish. All right, let's move on to the next one, Alien World. So this one's interesting because it has, like, outside of Axie Infinity, this one has, like, some of the most daily active users, which is obviously a huge metric for a project's success. People are actually using it. So this one's live. It's usable. It's already had its own little mini bull market here, and it's trading in like a nice range right around here. Currently sitting at 25 cents. It ran up at one point to 38 cents. So with a working product, all the narratives that you could possibly want, I think there could be some upside here if this gaming, you know, momentum continues in the space. So what is it? Alien Worlds is a decentralized, non-fungible token NFT metaverse where players compete for scarce resources, Trillium, TLM, that's their native ticker, in a stimulated economy centered around planetary worlds. Due to this, Alien Worlds also has DeFi element to the game as players advance by staking TLM and using TLM to vote in the DAO. So that's cool. Like, different planets that are playing in this world actually have their own DAOs being governed by real crypto communities, gamers, and people who are excited about it. So the government's token, if you own it and you're holding it and you're staking it, you can essentially use it in the DAO to have a vote in the governance and which way the project is going, you know, how they bring on value or use value in the governance token. And I think that that is pretty awesome and unique and interesting way that gaming is going forward. Let's take a look at their website real quick. So this one, I think you need a Wax wallet actually to use this one. So I don't have that. I wasn't able to like start playing it. But essentially, you can come over to alienworlds.io, connect. You can find a community to get involved in. Learn the basics here. Number one, Alien Worlds is an NFT metaverse where you can play with unique digital items. You can stake. You can get involved in the planet, DAOs. You can trade different game cards, and you can cross-chain bridge, teleporting your TLM between BSC, WAX, and Ethereum network. Let's see what we can see on this little trailer. Very rousing music. Anthemic.
fledgling extraction colony floating high above Magor will soon receive
a
boost with their first delivery of manatite. This ultra-radioactive compound has been too dangerous for the Federation to transport using conventional ships. But now the missioner's bespoke G-Core transporter crafts, boasting tokamak-grade triple-leaded...
Trailer didn't speak to me very deeply on any kind of deep emotional level. It just didn't resonate to me too hard. Maybe this is the kind of thing that you like. Again, this is a working project with a ton of daily active users. This is stuff that is happening right now. It's not just a trailer. It's not just an idea. You can jump on this right now. I think you'll need the Wax wallet. So if I come down here and I click play and earn... But yes, I believe you need a Wax wallet, and you'll probably need some funds in there to get started playing this. Thanks for watching again, you guys. I hope you liked this video. Hop on over to dungeon.fyi, drop in your email address, and I'll send you an email as soon as my Discord is open. You'll get access to two roles, which will get tagged to your account automatically, Cleric and Archmage. Archmage will give you lifetime free access to any locked down community area in the Discord, and you'll be one of the first to get it. So I hope you guys like this video, and I'll see you on the next one.